single death recorded. Only one death. That's of someone who died within 28 days.
I just can't believe it. I mean, we've gone from having over 900, 1,000 deaths a day back in January and last year and stuff.
On vaccinations, more than 34.5 million people have now had their first dose of a COVID vaccine, and more than 15.5 million people have had
I'm one of those 15.5 million people. Okay, so yesterday we had a really lovely trip to Hereford to see my mum, and Marcus saw mum in person for the first time since January last year, 2020. Yeah, it's just so crazy that it's been as long as that, but obviously that has been the situation for so many people, not seeing family for ages. Hopefully that was the last time that we have to do it in a sort of distanced, abnormal way. I'm hoping that next time we catch up and meet up, it will be with hugs and proper family reunion, really. Please let it be so. Okay, also, I got this ring clipped off my finger yesterday because it doesn't fit anymore and it was really starting to crush against my middle finger. Do you know what? I have had this ring on forever. I mean, my dad gave me this ring basically when I was really, really young, back when it didn't even fit me. And when it did fit me, I think I was in my late teens, early 20s, probably my late teens, in fact. I put this ring on and I honestly don't think I've ever took it off until now. It's been on my finger this entire time. That is best part of almost 30 years. I mean, I went clubbing with this ring on. I gave birth with this ring on. Everywhere that I've travelled, worked, been, visited, taken part in any event, I've always had this ring on. So it was a little bit emotional, but it really did need to come off. So it's been clipped off. It's gold. It's got a little ruby in it. And I'm going to keep it safe. Maybe down the line I'll get it rewelded. But for now, yeah, it's like the end of an era. Totally the end of an era. I swear that I have made a stupid mistake. I've come out without a coat. When it was sunny, I left the house. And now, randomly, it's absolutely tipping down rain. We even had hailstones. I mean, how does it go from this to this? For goodness sake, why have we got hailstones? It's May. I'm not impressed. Yeah, that's like twice that I've been out and I've been caught in the rain. Right, I'm gonna go in and see my client and hopefully not look like a drowned rat when I walk into her apartment. Let's go.
That the joke was on me.
Say hello. Hey Rod, it's so good to see you. Are you excited?
Yeah, yeah. I've started the gym again. When I, an awesome wonder, consider
all the world's thy hands. Yeah, it's another Monday night, although it's actually Tuesday, so we didn't meet up on the bank holiday, so we're having our little connect group tonight instead. So we're just waiting for one more person. Let's all smile.
Yeah, you won't be able to see the smile though, will
you? Good to see you all.
Now, this may not be a general election, but these polls and the results could prove incredibly important across much of Britain.
Today is the local elections, so it's a chance for the community to go out and vote for who they want in local government. You can elect people for all the major parties, Conservative, Labour, and a couple of others. You can vote to keep the Conservatives locally, or you can vote for someone else to take over if you're not happy with them. Hey, we voted. Did that feel like the greatest moment of your life, Con?
No. You?
No. now that I voted, I'm just going to sit back and see how the election goes with my favourite chocolate, Bourneville. You can keep your Brussels. There's lots of housework that needs doing. You know when you just can't get into it at all. I'm just looking at things that need to be done around the house and just... Blah. I wish I could click my fingers like Mary Poppins and for everything to put itself away. Not gonna happen. I'm just gonna have to get on with it. So it's been a pretty active week and it's not over yet, because although this is my weekend off, I'm doing a live-in call starting tomorrow with my client. And yeah, it's gonna be a long weekend. When I wake up tomorrow, we should have an idea about the election results. I can't say I'm that massively excited or bothered about it, to be honest. I don't think a lot's going to change at the moment. We just want to get out of this pandemic. And that's got to be the main focus, really, moving forward. I'm looking forward to going back to church. We've had meetings about that now. I'm looking forward to in-person gatherings, as we're calling them at the moment. You know, just mixing with people again and going to church. That's something that I really look forward to.